as I need.
Lovely. Cheers. Bye.
Adult trauma call, 8 minutes. Adult trauma call, 8 minutes.
I've got an unconscious gentleman. He has severe traumatic brain injury.
King's College Hospital, London.
I think something hurt.
One of the busiest A&E departments in the country.
They're a bit busy right now. Yeah, you're 30 minutes, 30 minutes.
King's is extreme, isn't it? Come on.
A place where love, life and death... unfold every single day.
Fall from a tree. He's probably absolutely trolleyed.
I'm very drunk.
I just keep thinking, am I going to cope?
All the patients you're about to see were treated in one department in just one 24-hour period. Camino.
Everyone should walk through an emergency room at least once in their life, because it makes you realise what your priorities are. It's not the rush, rush, rush and the money, money, money. It's the people you love. And the fact that one minute they might be there and one minute they might be gone.
Every day, 60,000 people in the UK visit A&E.
No, this one was stretched nice.
Right.
Terribly wrong.
I'll try my best to sort of just bring it together and close it up.
350 of them are treated here at King's.
You think they'd see me pretty quick, wouldn't you? Because obviously every time I move my eye, it's just scratching a little bit more. It's more like it's not painful, it's more like irritating.
Yeah, like you are.
Do we have a portal placed in near a CT? Thank you.
Up to 140 staff work 24 hours a day. They're prepared for anything.
Just to test whether the battery was working.
And so, the gun was loaded?
Yes.
And you didn't realise that the gun was loaded?
Yeah, there you go.
People coming in with their coughs, colds, a cut on their end of their finger, to the extreme of people being thrown out of cars in the ambulance bay who've been shot.
Man with nailed hands. That's the gun.
Ooh!
Right result.
It's not a fetish having injured people coming through the door. Well, for whatever reason, you still get a buzz from hearing the words gunshot wound. It just sounds sexy.
Just take some deep breaths for me. Say 99 for me.
99.
And again.
45.
And again.
99.
All those people that have chopped off limbs, digits, people that have fallen over and dislocated their shoulders, I salute you. Thank you so much for making my job enjoyable.
Have you got glass in there?
Probably. That's coming through a lot more. I wasn't there about a minute ago.
I thought, oh my God, my God, my son's gonna lose his hand, or he's gonna bleed to death, or things you put me through. God, he put me through earlier with the police and then this. I mean, what are you trying to do?
Right, well, the police thing has kind of died out.
Yeah, no, I know.
You know, when my 5 months are done, my record's clean again. It gets wiped off. The yacht people told me that.
You've got lovely ears.
I do.
Hasn't he? He has. He's got really nice ears. No, you've got real...
That me,
that's
yeah?
you.
That's about time.
19-year-old Alex Ford is being seen in Minors, where non-life-threatening injuries are treated.
My name's Kim. I'm one of the emergency nurse practitioners. So, what happened today?
I just got a bit angry and put my hand through a double glazed.
I'll just stand over here, mind my own beeswax.
Well, good one.
Special. Oh, no, I can look at it.
That we're going to have to stitch.
Yeah.
Tess?
Do you like that one, Mum?
No.
That one was Hollywood for you, yeah?
No.
Do you know what it looks like, Mum? Do you know when the zombie bites into your hand?
Yeah, it's all right, yeah. Oh, God.
What I'm going to do, I'm going to send you round to X-ray.
Yeah.
We'll have a look, see if there's any glass in it, and that one up here is going to be stitched.
Yeah. It felt quite good, actually. I know that sounds bad, but when I did it, it was like an achievement. Like, I've just broke a window, yes, with my hand. It's double glazing, wow.
I think I might be stuck in the suture room for about 2 weeks trying to sew this bloke's hand up. Nice, great big laceration on the hypotheno, on the theno eminence, right down here.
Lovely.
So what you get when you lose your temper at 17 and put your hand through a glass door.
Yep, right.
They think that we can just put them back together brand new and that they're invincible. I'll be doing that too often, I hope. That we've got spare parts in the drawer. And we just, you know, a bit like Meccano set.
I was going to stay out. I was just going to stay at home in bed with the curtains drawn and just sleep it off. But obviously, I ain't going to sleep off a bit of metal stuck in my eye, am I?
Could Dr. Robbie contact him on 2405?
I know my eye hurts, but do you get feeling in your eye? Has it got nerves like your fingers?
No, I don't think it has.
like there, do you know what I mean? It's not really, you can feel it, but not really.
No, but when they pop your eye out and it's hanging down,
yeah.
Shut up. That's what they do, seriously.
Yeah, VR.
It makes your legs go like that, straight away, like that. That's why they put you in a chair, you're clamped in, they pop it out with like a silver spoon thing, and it's hanging here on a bit of tissue, yeah? Like that. And then they fiddle with it and do whatever they need to.
No.
Yes, they do.
Not my eye, they're not.
Well, what do you say?
So when they take your eye out, what is behind it? What's behind your eye?
It's a lot of nerve things, isn't it? I don't know, three tendons, isn't it?
Yeah, but what is that bit there? What is behind it? Is it like skin?
No, it's just hard, isn't it? It's flesh. When they pop that out.
Disgusting, man.
What have you done?
Clicked
the wrong patient off?
Yeah. Yeah, the patient I'm about to see. And it's me. Guess what I've done? I've just discharged a patient I've not seen yet. Yeah, it will, won't it? Thanks a lot. Bye. Ah, you see, this is what happens when you make me get up in the morning to come to work.
What do you want to be?
What do I want to be? A legend.
No, what do you want to
That's
be?
That's it. I just want to be remembered. Is that a problem? You're not listening. It's the easiest. It's a job. Without no one really, like, I want to be remembered. Like.
You
like
Jesus?
No. Yeah, but I want to be remembered. Like, I don't want to be a nobody. I want to be a somebody. Like Achilles.
My little baby. My baby. Your mummy's baby.
Mm-hmm.
Don't grow up.
I have to.
Don't grow up. Be mummy's baby forever.
Sorry, Mum.
Oh, that's all right.
You've
got to calm down. My little boy's growing up too fast. Did your mum and dad...
Do you know what you can get me for Christmas? You know what you can get me for Christmas? A punching bag. Because you know that would be the best thing for me when I get angry. Just go and work it out.
I was going to get you something really nice for Christmas.
What a punching bag will do.
No.
Anyone, just tell anyone in the family, get Alex a little small punching bag.
He's always had what he wanted, this one.
I have, I'll give them that.
If he wanted a flat screen telly, he got one.
Think about it back in the day.
If he wanted a console, he got it.
Okay, I'm going to give it a good irrigation, a good clean out. We have to develop relationships very quickly because we're about to do some horrible things to you. We're about to hurt you, basically, and it's legal.
My hand.
Yeah.
He puts his hand through a glass window, then he needs some way to hold his hand while he has an injection. Sorry, darling. Sorry, sorry, sorry.
I've just got a vision of Drogba scoring against Arsenal for some reason, and that really hurts.
You're doing well. You've certainly done it. Good job on this, Alex.
I know. I will not. I probably won't ever hit anything ever again.
It might be a good idea, actually.
I'm just going to be some peacemaker now.
Yeah.
I'm going to go around the streets of Brixton preaching. Sorry.
It's very, very deep.
This may be a bit too much for us to do. We may have to send you...
I didn't even hit it that hard. I swear to God, I didn't.
Well, sometimes you don't. It's just the way you hit it, isn't it?
It was the angle, yeah.
Yeah, it was definitely.
It's like I did a martial arts move.
Sorry, Alex. I'm sorry, 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 sorry. I know that I'm hurting them, but I need to do it, and I'm always saying, I'm sorry, I'm sorry, I'm sorry, and I'm sure they don't believe me, and they're probably right not to.
Oh, I can remember being 17, 18, and thinking that I can do absolutely anything and nothing will happen to me. You know, that's just being a kid.
Right, we're going to have to hand you over to the orthopaedic doctors.
Oh, I used to take risks, do stupid things, like walk the other side of bridges and just ridiculous. Ridiculous behaviour. Drive my car really fast. I had my mini up on two wheels, round a roundabout. Oh, fucking crazy.
I'm such a moron. Oh. I won't be smashing anything ever again, though, because anytime I get angry, and I just look at it, and yeah. There's been times since where I've got angry, and you know what the reminder is? I can't even clench my fist. That's the reminder. Like, I can't even. It hurts doing that, so I just. Yeah. And I know the reason is that, the reason why I can't clench my fist is because I got angry in the first place, so yeah.
Hello, King's INE.
The red phone.
Yeah.
A direct line from the ambulance service to the emergency department. When it rings, it signals the imminent arrival of a seriously ill patient.
Okay. All right, thank you. Oh.
How many minutes did they say? It's about 5 or 6 minutes.
Adult red phone in 5 minutes.
Of the 100 patients brought here by ambulance each day, on average, 10 of them are victims of road accidents.
Brendan is 31 years old and a motorcyclist. He's ridden head-on into a motor car. He's bullseyed the windscreen and has gone into the tank of his motorcycle complaining of groin pain. His injuries seem to be isolated to bilateral fractures of the wrists and he has an injury to his right testicle. His scrotum is discoloured. He complains more pain in the right testicle than the left testicle. Nothing else for you.
They're in a completely alien environment. One minute they're riding their motorbike or something, the next minute there they are strapped down to a bed, lying stark naked with about 8 people around them with some strange man putting their finger up their bottom.
Brendan, we need to put a drip in because you've broken both your wrists, or you might have. I'm going to put one in your ankle, so it's going to be quite uncomfortable, OK? Just to let you know.
OK.
All right. Never mind, just holding his ankle for a minute. This is going to really hurt. Sorry.
You know, and they're in pain and they've got no idea what's happening. All they can see is the ceiling. You know, they've got no idea what's going on and it must be petrifying.
I'm from the waterworks side.
OK.
Down below. The important
thing is,
don't mind all this other stuff.
We'll all fix, yeah.
Right?
Yeah.
The consultant has told me that you have an injury down below. How does it feel?
It just felt like I've been heavily booted in the nuts.
I think side?
It's just the right testicle was giving me a bit.
Have you ever had any problems with your testicles before?
No, not to my knowledge.
Your fellas
are right. Thanks. Thanks a lot, mate.
No, you're right.
It looked like a purple carrot, I can tell you that much. I thought it was touch and go at one stage, because a couple of days when I was on the ward, going to the toilet thinking, lifeless. There's not a lot going on down there, and not even the nurses can help me out in that respect, and it's lifeless. I'm like, OK, well, hopefully when I get back home, you know, might see some signs of improvement. But it was black and blue for a couple of weeks.
Food trolley.
I do have.
Alice has brought her sister Pat into A&E after a fall on a shopping trip.
Cheese and pickle there, egg and cress, savoury cheese. Savoury cheese is quite nice.
Give it a try.
You want to give it a try? Yes, sir. And you're entitled to have a drink and a crisp with it for £3.49. That's a meal deal.
He had them on that trolley. Yeah, he did. He said, sandwiches.
When I see biscuits, I never see.
No, the sandwiches I think were on the top. He did say sandwiches. Yeah, he did say it.
Good trolley.
But you don't know when they were made. They could have been last week's. I was looking forward to me fish and chips. But there you go.
I didn't know what time today I'm going to have a sandwich. It's 1 o'clock, isn't
it? I don't know, I ain't got a watch.
Quarter past one. Thank you. Mind you, Denise said, would you want to have that money? It's too much. He went, you wouldn't live to spend it. She went, if so, I won a millionaire, that would see me through.
Yeah, but they've both got families, don't they, that they can leave it to?
Yeah.
That's a good part.
Yeah, and
they could go bust just like that.
Why should that leave it to them?
I mean, look at Gordon Ramsay, he's gone skint nearly, he's relied on Peter Jones for help.
He's only going to Peter Jones.
Yeah, that's what I say, with all his money.
All his money. So you can go bust.
I
wouldn't stick with him. I went this horrible man, flipping all the time, every word is there.
You're right.
Can I come
can
in with
that? Bag for me?
Yeah. What you got in here? Bomb?
Dr. Aisha, come to me, just please. Can Dr. Aisha come to me, just?
And have you been a smoker in the past?
Yes, yesterday.
Up until yesterday, okay. Have you been smoking for a long time?
Oh, I wouldn't say really that long. That late 70s.
Okay, and how many a day?
Well, drunkies down to 20.
It drives me nuts that people don't look after their health. There's only so much that we can do as doctors. We're not magicians.
Do you smoke quite a lot then? Breathe in and out through your mouth for me. That's it. Can you do it again? Good, and keep going.
Playing.
Sonic. I wanted brain training, but Leanne took it out and I can't find it.
This is the 35th time Lynn Brackley's been to hospital this year.
Shit.
Today, she's been brought in by her son, Lee, after collapsing with stomach pains.
Do you want a drink?
Linda Blackley.
Hi. How are you feeling? Are you in a lot of pain? Do you need something for the pain?
Mm-hmm. Okay. I've been asking for ages.
Sure. Can you tell me a bit about the pain? I'll assess your pain and I'll write something.
I was in 5 weeks ago.
Right.
Yeah. Mr. Patel took out my gallbladder.
Right.
I'll be truthful with you, I've had enough of being in pain.
Right.
Do you know what I mean? I've had enough.
Okay. I'm sorry about that, but we'll try and do something for you today.
Thank you.
Okay. And how are you coping at home?
I'm not. At the weekend, the pain was that bad that I really felt like doing something stupid. I did, because I've had...
Like what?
I haven't got a say, have I?
Yeah.
I haven't got a say, it's just...
No, I just want to know...
How I'm feeling.
No. If you thought of something...
I did, because I've had enough.
Right.
Do you know what I mean? I thought that once the gallbladder come out, after having the gastric bypass, my life would be different, but it isn't. It is because I've lost the weight, but it just seems to have opened up a can of worms, and I'm not dealing with the situation that good at the moment.
Have you had this thought before, or this is the first time you've had
it? No, I've had it before.
Hmm.
I have had it before.
And have you ever sort of...
Yes, I have done it before.
What have you done?
I have took an overdose before.
Okay. Just remind me why you had the bypass again?
Why? Because I was fat.
Okay, that's fine.
And I couldn't lose.
How fat were you?
I was 29 stone.
Okay, and now?
I am 15 stone 13.
So you're getting more and more thoughts of harming yourself recently, is that right?
Yeah, because of the pain.
Oh, okay.
When you're fat, everything gets put down to your size.
Mm.
Yeah? And people don't actually look into the situation. It's, there's nothing wrong with you. It's your size that's causing the problem.
Mm-hmm.
Like, big people have rights as well, you know?
Yeah, they surely do.
You know, but because you're big, they just discard that.
Mm. Okay.
But they can't do that no more because I'm still big, yeah?
Mm.
But I'm not as big as what I was.
Yeah.
So they can't do that to me no more.
Sure.
So I'm not gonna take that.
Okay, fine, just tell me if it hurts a lot, I'll be gentle.
Fat people have rights as well. We have feelings just as much as skinny people or anything else. Do you know what I mean? If anything, fat people might have more feelings than skinny people. To be quite honest with you, because I think that fat people are more loving.
Okay, what I'm going to do, I'm going to put an injection in your wrist here. That's going to numb it,
mm-hmm.
and then I'm going to pull it and we're going to put a plaster on.
Right.
So I'll get one of my colleagues. It goes from here to here.
Oh, right.
X-rays show that 78-year-old Pat has broken her arm.
Nance, do you want somebody to help you pull?
Would you mind getting the plaster trolley for me?
I will.
If you're going to be my glamorous assistant. Have to batter her up.
Take that last time, please. Thank you.
One of these days, this is going to fall apart. I can see it's going to be on me. Oh!
I think she's all herself.
Yeah, she's not bothered.
Talking about me again.
No, darling, no. We can't let
that die. Right.
I'm trying to tell her some good news. Hang on. Tiger Woods.
Here's another one, paid too much.
Dirty sausage. She likes Johnny Depp.
I love Johnny Depp.
I've got a photo of him just above my oven.
When I'm cooking
the oven. I have. No, it's on my tie.
He is absolutely gorgeous.
When I'm cooking, I've got a full eye view of him there.
You're going to get that one day.
I really don't care.
You're going to get all splash. Come out.
I don't care.
She'd go through torture. She'd just look.
Oh dear. What you got to do is when I'm doing this, you've got to think of Johnny Depp.
I'd let him pull it without doing the needle.
Oh,
love him.
He is gorgeous, isn't he?
How come I'm doing this, by the way?
Because you're my glamorous assistant. Go on with it.
It's going up my nose and everywhere.
Think of yourself as Angelina Jolie.
That's right.
Oh, she's nice, Angelina.
No, my pal. No, I've gone off Angelina. No, since she stole Brad from Jennifer.
I'm not into Brad Pitt either.
Right. Claire, would you both like a cup of tea?
Oh, lovely. Could you? Have there any sandwiches in here?
Oh, I was going to get you a sandwich, wasn't I? I will get you a sandwich as soon as I've done this,
oh,
I promise you.
Get us a sandwich.
I will get you a sandwich.
Lovely,
yeah.
Oh,
yes,
yeah.
Once we've done
yeah.
this.
He's doing about 20-30, the car's doing about 20-30, and Vicky's had her head on pretty much, so...
Oh, okay.
I think he's just quite lucky that he's been thrown from the bike, and when he's thrown, he's just sort of thrown and landed.
He's been thrown.
Yeah, and it's probably the best thing, though, if he hadn't done that, he would just impact with the car and he had a lot worse injuries.
It's 3 hours since Brendan Fox was first admitted. It's clear his injuries are non-life-threatening. Does your job make you more aware of your own mortality and think about your own death and those that you love?
I think there's days where it does. There's definitely days where it does. Yeah.
I could be brown red, so it don't really matter. About two broken wrists, it's that'll heal. No, all in. Thank lucky stars. Because had something been coming down the bus lane, i.e. a bus, could have been interesting.
Now that I'm married and I've got a baby on the way, I'm even more aware of it. And I'm even more aware of, actually, I might be dead in 10 years, let alone 40 years.
Very scary, was it?
No, but I just think it's somebody trying to tell me something that there's only so many lives you've got.
How many have you used up?
Well, today, I reckon I've used a bloody good chunk of them, because, quite easily have been dead, so... Wasn't my time, so...
Every day when you go out on the bike, there's always a nearly. You nearly got me, got away with that one. And eventually, your luck runs out. You know, the odds are at some point you're going to get it, but how you escape or how you get away with it is it's all down to luck at the end of the day.
Thank you very much, everybody, for your help. You've been
out. You coming? You got rid of me?
Yeah.
Bye, thanks.
King's Army. Hello. Lovely. Cheers, bye.
Red phone, 2 minutes. Red phone, 2 minutes.
Hello, Kings.
Adult trauma, red phone, 3 minutes.
This is George. Conscious today with a bit of difficulty in breathing.
I love resus. It can be a bit stressful if we've got more than the five patients in there, because we've only got five trolleys.
And how long? But head injury.
But it's a buzz. The adrenaline's amazing.
This is Alan. He's 50 years of age. Fell down about 7 carpet stairs onto a carpet floor.
I've never ever had a problem with the sight of blood. The crunch of bones when I'm putting fractures back to place. I think that's great. Even seeing someone's chest being opened in resus. It's not ideal, but it doesn't faze me. Great for me personally, not for them.
No, he can go. He can he can sit here.
That's what I was thinking.
This one's going to go to X-ray. That he can move there and then...
Yeah.
Yeah. Okay. If we get another trauma in the next 20 minutes, I'll be upset.
Absolute carnage. Right, how many red phones is this now? Because this is nearly getting close to my 15 in a bloody shift.
15, you reckon?
Yeah. I only did 11 the other day.
56-year-old Michael Brown crashed his van on the way home from work.
Chest on the steering wheel. He's got Parkinson's. Okay. Left side tremor is normal for him.
Yeah.
He says this is quite bad. It gets bad when he's stressed, which obviously
he's stressed.
He's calmed down quite a lot, but it's just got bad again.
Okay. Michael, have you got any pain on your legs? Can you lift this leg up for me? Lift it up all the way. Cool. And this one? Lovely.
Michael, my name's Firas. I'm one of the A&E consultants here.
Mm-hmm.
Okay. How are you doing?
I'm all right.
Yeah. You feel me quite anxious?
It's just my kind of keeping.
I know. It's very easy for me to say try and relax, okay? But do try and relax as much as you can.
Yeah.
I'm not worried about you, but let me put it that way.
No,
okay.
I'm all right.
Just because of what's happened and what symptoms you've got, I think we just need to be a little bit more cautious.
Yeah.
But I'm hoping that we'll get you up and out by this evening's end.
Okay. Okay. That's good. Thank
you. Well, I just thought I could have lost them. Could have been a lot different. That was basically the main thing that went through my head, you know? I could have lost them, and he could have been a lot more seriously hurt. He's always been the strong one. He's always been there for me. It was just horrendous to see him like that, and I hope I never see him like that again.
Hiya. Look at him, is he crying? So why are you upsetting him, huh? Huh? Look at him, he's smiling. Please don't upset him, he's been doing fine. He was so brave until you guys came along. I'm not worried about him. It looks scary and freaky, okay? If I was worried, I would tell you. What we're gonna do, we're gonna x-ray there and there and down there. If those x-rays are fine, we can give them back to you.
Well, good.
Is that a deal?
Yeah.
Okay.
One-year-old George Rumsey lives with his great-nephew, Jay.
Things a little bit, isn't it?
That's the oldest one I've ever in.
George has been brought to A&E with breathing difficulties.
OK, that's all done, sir.
I'm going home now. Yeah,
Thanks for coming up here.
Oh, that's all right. Don't let yourself get into a situation like that again, you know.
You need to
breathe
to live, all right? Well, it's better for
people who haven't been up
here
like
this. Oh, they sort you out. Yeah, we'll sort it out. Thanks
very
much. Thank you. Thank you, anyhow.
All right.
Bye-bye. Only sitting down.
Yeah. He's just really down-to-earth bloke, really lovely, heart of gold. He'd do anything for you.
12. 5 to 12, yeah.
Well, he treated me as his own son and always looked after me. We just used to go to Banger Racing and go down to the Donkey Man and just used to go on the donkeys and stroke them and things like that.
Well, if anything, if you're here overnight, I'll bring something cut for you tomorrow.
Whenever I needed someone to talk to, he was always there and I could go into him any time, really, night or day.
King's A&E. OK. Thank you. 80-year-old cardiac arrest. Prevail port to Rhesus with a striker trolley, and can I have an A&E doctor to Rhesus immediately? Thank you. Two, please, number two.
An elderly man has suffered a heart attack.
Just get some paddles on and see what we've got, okay?
Most patients who have a cardiac arrest away from hospital don't survive.
Right. Anyone felt for a pulse?
Yeah, present. Pulse is present, yeah.
Okay.
We got a pulse.
Any rhythm? Yeah, we've got a sinus rhythm. I think we've lost rhythm.
Yeah. We're going to start CPR again.
Yeah. Sorry, where's the family?
If I ever get to the age of 85 and have a cardiac arrest, I do not want to be dragged to an emergency department with people pouncing on my chest, people putting tubes down my throat.
Right, okay. Somebody else do a pulse check because I'm not going to be reliable.
What's the point? If a person dies in that circumstance, it's not dignified. I just want to die at home in peace.
After several attempts to resuscitate the patient, he is pronounced dead.
When you get older, maybe you do spend a lot of time contemplating things and thinking about what has happened and maybe you could have done something better. I don't know. I've never asked anybody. Maybe it'll make me, a bit too emotional. Maybe I don't want to know those answers.
Feeling better?
Yeah.
Basically, they just kept him in. And then the next day, I come up to see him, and he seemed fine. So I get a phone call the following morning saying he's had two heart attacks, and then they've had to shock him twice. So I've come up here. I can't remember if it was that night or the day after he passed away. He had another heart attack and passed away. It just probably was his time.
You've got to remember who to be nice to.
You've got to still care about the people that actually deserve it.
Like that little old man last night. Little weight, 9-year-old who had fallen down his stairs, and he had like multiple rib fractures, contusions, bilateral brain contusions. He had pneumothorax one side, pneumothorax the other side. I mean, he was in a sorry old state, and it just broke. And the vicar came and did the last rites. Well, me and the anaesthetist were nearly in tears outside here. Because he was just, you know how lovely he obviously was, and his daughter, he lived with his daughter and his son-in-law, and they just couldn't, you know, he always kept the place tidy and did the washdown and had just, you know.
Soon as they die, they've gone. The person, they're just a shell. They don't look like they did. And it's funny, because even if you've only known that person, been with that person for 5 minutes, when they're dead, they don't look what they looked like when they first came in.
Right, well, let's get him kind of somewhat reasonable. I might take...
Could I have a portrait x-ray, please?
What makes your features in your face and everything else just goes.
Is it rolling to me?
Yeah. Good lad.
Good guy. I mean, I must admit, I do talk to the bodies, though, when I'm laying them out. Well, I think they could be watching. I'd hate for anyone to think that I was treating them horribly. Do you know what I mean? I think it's just... I don't know whether it's a... Maybe it's a getting-over-it mechanism, coping mechanism, maybe. I don't know, but I've always done it. I've always spoken to the bodies.
Sorry, mate. Oh, that wasn't great, was it? Managed to make a mess of that side now.
They can sometimes ooze from their back passage. They're, you know, come out there, they can wee. And sometimes when you turn them, it can all come out of their mouth as well. It depends. Sometimes you don't have any, and sometimes you have a lot. And sometimes they moan when you turn them over. But that's just because there's a lot of air in the lungs. They go, like that. The first time I heard it, I did run out of the room, but I was only 22. I was a baby.
Well, you've got some suction. Let me just suck out what's come out. Don't be making a mess like that with your family, all right? Because that won't be nice, will it? That's better, isn't it? It looks much more comfortable. All right, mate. There.
It does affect me, because I realise how amazing life is. I realise that I don't ever want it to end, and I hope to God that I end up as fit as a flea for very many years. But I don't think it... I do have a really black and white view on death. You know, people die, it's upsetting, it's horrible, but it is a fact of life.
Tempting to move, just keep it still just for a few minutes longer.
I ring him a lot more during the day to check on him and that. And I do get up and cook him his breakfast some morning. Just basically, you know, like, don't take him so much for granted, you know? It makes you think that you should take that extra time because you never know what the outcome of the day is going to be.
Right, should we start in one and work our way down?
No.
So, it is.
Ailing Kings, what do you think?
Ah, oh, brilliant. Thanks so much. And bye. Red phone, 8 minutes, please. Yeah.
62-year-old male with chest tightness.
Red phone, 8 minutes.
For last
phone,
hour. Hello, King's A&E.
Got some bad news for you, man. Coffee got knocked over today.
We have another trauma call coming in with a stab wound.
There's a guy over there with a knife sticking out of his head.
Yeah. This gentleman has just walked into reception. He's been shot in the face.
Yeah, it's Wild West tonight.
It's the stuff of movies. But we get it sometimes at work.
Thank you.